Welcome to Bjorkboda Marsh, a prairie pothole wetland in central Iowa. Bjorkboda is a publicly accessible wildlife refuge in Hamilton County, Iowa. It can be accessed from 100th Street, Boone, Iowa, between Inkpaduta and Hammond Avenues. Bjorkboda Marsh is a remnant prairie pothole wetland surrounded by a mix of remnant and reconstructed prairie. The 36.5-acre site was donated by Ruth Weed, who grew up on a nearby farm. The wetland was named Bjorkboda because it reminded Ruth's ancestors of a place in Sweden. Prairie pothole wetlands are found in the Des Moines Lobe. Prairie pothole wetlands were formed by glaciation, or glaciers moving over the land, carving out depressions in the landscape, and depositing glacial till. Bjorkboda is located within the Altamont Moraine, a ridge made up of rock and sediment that were moved and deposited by a glacier. Very few natural wetlands remain in this area. Hamilton County has only 0.5% of the wetlands it had in 1840. The prairie and wetland mosaic that existed in this area at the time created highly fertile soil desirable for row crop agriculture. Within the late 1800s, much of Iowa's prairies were tilled up to make room for row crop. While the soil was fertile, it was also wet, making the land difficult to farm. To get rid of as many wet spots on the landscape as possible, tile drainage was installed on a large scale. Extensive tile drainage was installed to quickly move water off the soil, resulting in the drainage of the majority of wetlands in the Des Moines Lobe. Luckily, Bjorkboda was spared from drainage, but modifications have been made to its hydrology. A wetland's hydrology has to do with where its water is coming from, where that water goes, how long the water stays in the wetland, and how much water is in the wetland throughout the year. Prairie pothole wetlands are low spots or depressions in the landscape that are typically dependent on a mix of precipitation and groundwater inputs. They lose water to soil infiltration and evapotranspiration. Bjorkboda's hydrologic inputs come from not only precipitation and groundwater, but also from a drainage ditch with tile drainage flow. Bjorkboda loses water to another drainage ditch that ultimately flows into Iowa Creek. It is likely that the wetland helps improve the water quality of the tile drainage by reducing nitrate levels in the water before it ends up in Iowa Creek. Bjorkboda's hydrology is also impacted by a road that bisects the marsh. It is not uncommon to see wetlands in Iowa that have roads cutting through them. A road or other barrier makes it difficult for water to move freely throughout the wetland and from one basin to another. Barriers can also hamper the movement of wildlife like frogs, turtles, and aquatic invertebrates. When the barrier is a road, there's the added hazard of car strikes with wildlife of all kinds. Bjorkboda provides multiple ecosystem services or benefits to both humans and wildlife. Bjorkboda serves as important wildlife habitat, improves the quality of water flowing into Iowa Creek, and provides recreational opportunities. While there are no trails on site, visitors can use the viewing platform to birdwatch, observe wildlife, and take in the sounds of the marsh. Let's take a look from the viewing platform. Common animals that you might see in Bjorkboda include wood ducks, blue-winged teal, great blue heron, leopard frogs, and muskrat. Muskrat huts can be seen scattered throughout the marsh. These muskrat huts are made up of vegetation and mud and are home to not only muskrats, but can also serve as nesting platforms above the water for geese and other waterfowl. Bjorkboda also provides habitat for trumpeter swans. Trumpeter swans were almost driven to extinction in the 20th century, in part due to wetland drainage and habitat loss. As of 2020, over 100 pairs of trumpeter swans were reported to be nesting in wetlands across Iowa. Bjorkboda is a marsh, meaning that it is dominated by herbaceous vegetation. Herbaceous vegetation is vegetation that lacks woody stems, so you wouldn't find trees, shrubs, or very many vines within a marsh. Some of the more abundant plants in Bjorkboda include things like sedges, rushes, and grasses. All of these plants provide vital habitat and food for wildlife. Bjorkboda is an integral part of the landscape in Hamilton County and provides multiple ecosystem services like water quality improvement, wildlife habitat, and recreational opportunities. Thank you for joining us, and we hope you enjoyed our profile of Bjorkboda Marsh.